Good morning, guys. It is Monday. We just pulled up to work. We're about to get the work week started. This morning I got up early. I made chicken last night, so I made my vegetables and mashed potatoes today. So that way, when I get home from work, all I gotta do is heat up dinner, and I ain't cooking nothing. So anyway, let me get up in here. It is 7:59. I gotta be in there at 8 o'clock. I'm gonna let y'all know some other stuff later on this week. So stay tuned to this week's vlog. I'm gonna pick y'all back up when I get back home. Have an amazing day. All right. What's good, guys? I'm just sitting in my car. It's my lunch break. What I wanted to tell you guys is when you working for these places and around people all day long with different types of energies, especially bad ones, like miserable people, on your free time, meaning lunch, when you clocked out, you make sure that you get out of that building. Whether it's for a walk around the building, whether it's sitting in your car, whether it's going to grab lunch, make sure that you leave. Because before, I used to work through my lunches, or I would sit at my desk during my lunch and watch stuff on my phone and stuff. And I still sometimes watch things on my phone, but I'm not going to watch it in there. People interrupt your breaks and stuff, or you just might need a break, a breath of fresh air. You know, nothing wrong with that. Take this time on your free time to recenter yourself. Pray, meditate, take a nap in your car. I do that. I've done that plenty of times. To get yourself through the rest of the day. Right now it is almost 2:30. I took my lunch at 2:20. So yeah, like even though I get 30 minutes now because I changed my work schedule, I used to get an hour lunch. I'm spending from the time I walk out the building, that's when my 30 minutes start. And I'm not going to waste it in there. I'm not. So, you know, we already limited on the time that we have. You're supposed to sleep 8 hours. You're supposed to work 8 hours. And then you're supposed to have 8 hours of just free time, not even including the time that you travel back and forth to work, the errands that you gotta run. So it's really no time for you in the day. And that's how the system is set up. So my prayer is for like financial freedom, freedom of my schedule and stuff like that. So I'm able to make money so I can provide for myself, but not be confined to the regular 9 to 5. The regular building someone else's dream, putting money in somebody else's pocket. You know, these jobs, they want so much from you, but the pay is basic. They want the premium package, but the pay is basic. You know, when they hire you, they say, this is what you want to do and this is your pay. You like, all right, for what you say that I'm going to be doing, I'll take that pay. But then when you start, they start adding more and more and more and more and more and more stuff into your responsibilities and on your plate. When in all actuality, if that's just like me being a designer, if you ordered a specific dress and I gave you the price, that's what you're going to pay. You're not going to tell me to add all these other things, all these other details on top of it and expect for the price to build still be the same. That's what these jobs want, though. They want to add all this extra shit, the razzle dazzles onto it, but they don't want to give you the money that it costs for all that extra work that you're doing. So, yeah, that's my prayer. Like, Lord. And I done stepped out on faith before, you know. I just need something different because this is not it. It's not it for me. It was just a stepping stone for me moving into a new state. I needed employment. I came out here with no job and was able to get a job on my first interview. So this was it. And I just feel like it's time for elevation. This is not it. This is not it anymore. So That's all I wanted to say. I just wanted to say, be encouraged. Don't be scared or afraid to step out on faith. You know, because at the end of the day, if God has always provided, He is going to continue to provide. If you have that faith in Him, if you trust that He is your provider. So, yeah, I cannot wait to see what God has next for me in regards to my career. Like, because these people don't deserve me. They don't. They don't. They don't deserve not an ounce of me or my time. So, Lord, see me through. Anyway, I'm gonna get back with you guys a little later, probably when I get home or whatever. I'm gonna finish enjoying this quiet time on my lunch break, and I hope you guys' day is going well for you. Alright. I'll be having to make sure that this shit is positioned right. Anyway, it is 5:06 and I made it home. I am about to do some dishes, load the dishwasher, and heat up some dinner that I made partially last night and the rest this morning. Work was alright, you know. A lot of work went into like 400 emails that I had to sort through. Just a lot of work, not a lot of pay, you know, just a different day. House sway. What they say? Anyway, I got bars. Why? Hard as shit the way that it is. So let me do that because it's gonna bother me until I get these dishes done. I got the washer going, so that's probably loud, and then the dishwasher gonna be going, which is probably gonna add on to that. So I'm gonna pick y'all back up in a minute. Let me just get this done. What's good, y'all? It is Tuesday, June 27th. I am home, fresh from work. Tonight, we're going to make it simple because the other night I made chicken thighs, which my family hate thighs. I really don't like thighs like that neither. But I'm like, look, with the economy, we're going to have to change. We can't have chicken breasts and wings all the time because they're expensive. So let me get a pack of thighs. We ain't going to do drumsticks. We ain't going down that low. I don't know. I feel like thighs and drumsticks is like, they're like the same. But I think I can do drumsticks if they're the real small ones, like the skinny ones. If they're not real, real thick and meaty, I can do the drumstick. But it got to be like grilled and with barbecue sauce on it. Or like curry. Curry, because I can do curry thighs and stuff like that. But anyway, we're not even doing chicken thighs. I did thighs the other night. And I did mixed vegetables and mashed potatoes. So that's what we have for dinner. Tonight we are having our Target Good and Gather Steakhouse seasoned beef patties. I would have rather them not be seasoned, but these were the ones that were on sale. It looks like I'm the only one eating onion rings because there's only a few in here. And yes, the bag is beat up. And some Arby fries, but I'll put them in the air fryer once everything is done. But because this is not homemade burgers or whatever, I'm going to do my razzle dazzle. I'm about to put some red onions on and cook them. I bought some banana peppers home. We got some cheese. We got some potato hamburger buns. It kind of looked beat up because we put them in a deep freezer. We didn't want our bread to go bad, so we put it in a deep freezer. Yes, I'm looking like somebody's auntie. This is how I look when I go to work. It's no razzle dazzle. You know, I go like I go. And if you know, you know. Get with the flow. And I ain't gonna tell you no more. Yeah. So yeah, let me
It's 5:34. I did stay to work till 5 o'clock today because I have to leave early tomorrow for something. I did get finished editing my last video. This week's video that I record, matter of fact, no, this is a whole brand new week. I had last week's to edit. Y'all are getting tomorrow, the week before that. So that is already done and edited. My goal was to edit a little every day so it doesn't seem like it's like, because it is very time consuming. Making sure you cut off back, because I be playing music a lot when I'm cooking and cleaning and stuff like that. So because of copyrights, we can't have that in the background. So I be having to cut all my volume down and add music to it. Y'all know. So it just takes a lot of time to sit through all the footage that you have recorded and make sure that everything is right. Because once you download it, and it takes like an hour to download, and then it takes another hour to upload, like, yeah, that's a lot. That's a lot to have to be like, damn, I left music on this part, so now I gotta go back, take it off, and then export it again. Like, it's just too much. So every day, do a little by little. But what I found easier is putting all my label in a folder and putting all that footage, just moving it over into that folder. So I know all of these videos right here is for this vlog versus how I was doing it before. I was just recording mad videos and it was just all together and I didn't know what was for what, and it was just taking forever to separate. So yep, I'm doing what works for me. The work is working and it just twerking. Like, nah, but let me get this stuff ready so dinner could be done before baby go to work and my daughter can eat dinner too and I can eat dinner too and I can watch my shows, you know, and relax. I might have a glass of wine tonight. I'm in celebratory mode. Like, I feel like we gotta celebrate, you know. So with that being said, we still got some of the California roots. Sauvignon Blanc. Sauvignon Blanc. This one is 13.5%. It's my new shit. It was normally Pinot and Rosé. I like the white wines. But Sauvignon, it's not as dry as the other ones. I used to be a Moscato girl, but Moscato started to taste like juice and it wasn't doing nothing. So anyway, let me get to my duties. Cinderella, huh? Cinderella. All right, so I didn't have enough red onions cut up. Look at this, y'all. This bitch thinks she cute because she got hair. Sitting over there in the basket just growing. Usually when we see stuff like this, like growing on its own, we like to put it in dirt and see what it's gonna do. But I need the onions, so I don't know. It's so cute though. Oh my goodness, like my garden inside of me is like, girl, let it grow, let it grow. But we ain't got no more red onions, so. Anyway. I don't know. Damn, I wish we had another one. Alright, girlfriend, you about to get chopped. You about to get chopped. Alright. Good morning, guys. It is Wednesday, June 28th. And I just pulled up to work. It's 7:52, so I got a couple minutes before I go in. Today, some exciting things are happening. So hopefully I'm able to insert some of the things in the vlog or whatever. I know I've been talking about this for a while and I'm like, you know, I really can't say anything or whatever. So we are going to see what's going on today. I'm so excited. So as you can see, I put myself together just a little bit though, just a little bit.
And yeah, I'm gonna leave work a little bit early so I can make it there on time. And we will see. So I'm gonna catch up with you guys later. Let me go ahead and get my day started because I still have a lot of work to do. We have been swamped, yo. I've been averaging like getting in 400, 500 emails that I have to sort through a day on top of all the other work that I have to do. On top of work that I have to do for somebody else because they are out right now that I haven't even got a chance to get to. So it is what it is. I'm not a robot. I can do what I do, and that's it. All right, guys, catch up with you later. Bye.
What's good, guys? I am back. It's still Wednesday. I was in the car earlier when I was recording, so as you can see from the clip, the little clip that I posted before, we closed on our first home today. So excited. Like, I'm ready to start packing. I'm ready to be up out of here. No more listening to the Jolly Green Giant upstairs stomping. We ain't gotta listen to the dogs running no more. We get to get our dogs now. We get to do our gardening. I'm so excited because we about to kick up this channel to the next level. I've been waiting to do a gardening. We've been doing our balcony garden. We've been doing our thing. We know that we are capable of doing it. Now we got the land to do it. So I'm just so excited, you know. And this is a new chapter. A new chapter, just the beginning. Like, this is just the first home. This is not the forever home, but this is the first one. So I'm glad that we were able to accomplish that. And I just want you guys to stay tuned because I'm going to bring you along. I'm going to bring you along. We found one. We found one.